take this out. I called this meeting to order.
Is this your report, right?
Mm-hmm.
Correct.
Are you the chair?
I am.
You are the chair.
So I guess I
Captain.
Hereby call the Airport Transportation Committee of meeting of April 28th order. Philip, if you'd like to go ahead and do that, what you got?
Well, since everybody's new on the airport, and I don't think we've met since y'all got on council, as you may or may not know, Jacob worked with UAV Pro, which is actually what we call our fixed base operator, FBO. So, abbreviation, fixed base operator. Up until probably 5 years ago, 4 years ago, we didn't have anybody out there. It was unmanned, it was empty, and it wasn't great. UAV Pro, specifically Jacob's father, Joe Allman, they actually have their offices in what is called our administration building. And we'll take a ride out there and you'll see it's a brick building out there. And it's got bathrooms and a conference room and offices. I think you have a little workshop in the back. And there's a receptionist there from 8 to 4 every day now. And so if people need fuel, she can schedule fueling. She can schedule a courtesy car to drive into town to go eat and all those kinds of things for the airport. The airport is what we call a joint use facility. Okay, in 1984, the town of Blackstone wanted, I guess was approached by the federal government because they wanted to build that new runway. Okay, the runway was built, okay, probably in the mid-late 80s. I don't know if you guys remember, but there was a big new concrete runway that was built. You know where Alf and how long it is?
I believe it's 5,000. Right at 5,000? Depends on which direction you're coming from because there's a displaced threshold.
With the slopes and all that sort of thing. So the town owned several hundred acres at the airport in 1984. And the town and the federal government did a swap. We gave them the acres they needed in order to build the runway.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The town received 31 acres that it didn't own previously. I think it had a small footprint, much smaller with the old hangars and things that we'll see today. So the town took 31 acres. The federal government got over 200 acres. Doesn't sound like a good swap, but we got the runway constructed. The town was also given the property where the new armory is out on Route 40. I don't know if you knew that. And about $100,000 in cash. Okay, that was the swap. But the language in that swap specifically said it would be run and operated as a joint use facility, which means military and general aviation have equal standing. Okay, so the military couldn't say no general aviation except in the event of national emergency, or I guess the post commander could close the airspace if 9/11 happened or something like that again. So we're a joint use facility. The federal government, Department of Army, owns virtually everything out there except for that 31 acres that we have. We have subsequently sold to UAV Pro, who has subsequently leased about 12 acres for Textron Corporation, which is actually a drone manufacturer that's located out there. 70 employees, is that still?
So right now we're right at 70. At our high times, we were at somewhere around 150.
Okay. That's great.
So there's actually somebody who's out there manufacturing unmanned aerial vehicles. All right? Every day they're building them. They have stands and the guys are constructing them. And those, are they used as targets? Are they used as
They're strictly tactical surveillance drones. They're not weaponized. They're just about an 80 to 100 pound bird that are contracted overseas just for surveillance purposes.
Okay. So of that 31 acres, we sold about 12 acres to UAV Pro. Textron sits on that footprint, and the town still retains about 8 acres, which is right at the fence line. If you're driving down 40, it's adjacent to the fence, farthest from the airport. We still own that. Airport is much better. I talked to Jacob today. It used to really be tumbleweeds out there and nothing was going on. It looked kind of shabby and not much happening. The Army or National Guard Bureau has put a lot of money into upgrading their facilities. They're building a new tower, building a new administration facility, a new fire station, and that old hangar that you'll see out there that is, I don't know, a half dome. They've really redone that, repainted it, new roof, and it looks so much better out there. Our facilities look better because of what Joe and UAV Pro have done in there. We've worked on a new a new maintenance building that we built. We've tried to upgrade the hangars with new ramps and painting the rusty spots on the roof and that sort of thing. But overall, it is way much better than it was. More activity.
I was going to say, how much activity is out there?
mean, he can tell you about the unmanned and maybe the general aviation, but the military is really the bread and butter as far as what we're concerned. General aviation obviously has access and that sort of thing, but the town of Blackstone has a fueling concession there. We have a fuel farm. And so we sell fuel under contract to the military. It could be Air Force, it could be Coast Guard, it could be whoever comes through there, okay? And we have a contract, and it's based on plats, which means if you buy it at $2.20, we get this much. We get an increase, I think, of 35 cents or 50 cents on each gallon that we sell, and it fluctuates every day on the price. That's how we pay for our share of construction projects, is the sale of fuel. Two types of fuel. There's jet fuel, which is helicopters. It is, most military uses jet fuel. And then there's 100LL, which is 100 low lead gas, that general aviation, little, what you would think is a civilian aircraft, use those. Mm-hmm. Okay. So we have the fuel farm. We've got four guys, three now. I think one of them left, but we have three guys that are trained and certified to fuel aircraft.
Okay. Oh, awesome. Okay.
And so they go out there, they get overtime, they get $1 an hour on their base salary, plus they get all the overtime that they get, mm-hmm. if they get on call or something like that. And those guys must like overtime because they don't complain too much about it. So we've got the fuel concession. We have hangars out there that we rent pretty cheap, like $100 a month. So we're not making a killing on those rascals, but the fueling really is the money generator out there. And when we get into budget season, you'll see an airport, you'll see fuel sales, revenue, and all that sort of thing. Biggest purpose for tonight is not only to educate you guys a mm-hmm. little bit about what's going on out there and take a ride, but we had a pre-construction meeting today at 11 o'clock. The town of Blackstone, we wrote a grant application with our engineer. We have an engineer called Talbert and Bright that the town had contracted with. They helped us put an application in and gave us all the cost estimates to reconstruct the apron. And the apron area, and we'll go out there and show it to you. The apron area is basically where the planes can taxi in, fuel, and if they want to tie down, they can tie down on it. And when I say tie down, with a rope attached to the ground so the airplane doesn't move. That has gotten in poor condition, a lot of cracking. We sealed it once since I've been here in 10 years, and it's just cracking more. The application was sent to the Department of Aviation first. Last year, we applied for the engineering and the design work, received a grant, $40,000 grant to do that. This year, we applied for the construction, and believe it or not, we received a $459,000 grant to redo this project.
Wow, that's
awesome.
The
town's got to match that with $114,000, and ultimately that $114,000 is going to come from the fuel sales. Okay. I don't have it sitting in the account right now, but we hope during the summer and the spring season, while there's more military, then we'll have enough money to pay for that. Okay. But we didn't expect it to be that expensive. The engineer's estimate was in the 300s, and it came back $125,000 more than estimate, but the Department of Aviation still put in their share. And so we matched it, and so we'll be out there. Pre-construction meeting, there will be a notice to proceed. All the contracts are signed, and all the documents are signed. And their contract date, because they have 60 days, I think, to finish it up. And they have a certain number of days to finish it, and that will begin next week. Okay? We expect the month of May and the month of June for the fueling to be disrupted out there. We're going to try to figure out, I found some pipe that we can carry out there. We're going to build a temporary taxiway so an airplane could get to the fuel farm if they needed to. It's a big project. It's really, I think, going to set off. It's obviously one of many future projects out there. Lighting, we looked at those, they were pretty shabby, and so there's plenty of stuff to do, but I got to concentrate on getting this one paid for, because it ain't paid for yet, not on the town side. So we're going to have to front the money and then pay ourselves back as fuel comes in.
The good news is with fronting the money with something like fueling, the gas is going to sell eventually. We're eventually going to pay ourselves back, just about how quickly do you do it.
Like, we hope over the course of spring and summer we'll get the money back. But, so you know, when I was a very enthusiastic young town manager in 2013, we had a lot of fueling. I mean, a lot of fuel. In 2012, our financial condition was really bad in town. We weren't in good shape at all. But we built Rigglesworth Baseball Softball Complex using aviation fuel we sold to the military. I didn't know, but at the time, I said, man, look at all this cash, man, we could build something really cool out here. And we used fueling money. Department of Aviation said, we don't like that anymore. Thank God we had finished before I told them. But all of the fuel proceeds have to go back on the site.
Okay.
So I can't build football stadium food gas money anymore. It's gotta go back on the facility.
That makes sense.
Okay, so I got a slap on my hand, but I never went any farther other than don't do it again. It turned out good. A little mistake, but it turned out good. We a lot of fuel in that year. In 2013, I think it was almost $400,000 worth of jet fuel profit that we put into the bubble, unless I would build.
Awesome.
I don't know what time you want to go. You want to run now?
Yeah, I can get the rest of this fuel on the bus if that works.
You want to ride in the bus with us?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll ride in the bus.
You kind of save some time. I know that. Forgive me, I forget. I forget who has a meeting after this, but
yeah,
I know.
The